Well, hello everybody, it's Bug Eater 64 and welcome to another day and another flight. Yesterday we did a flight from Barksdale Air Force Base, Louisiana, to Dallas-Fort Worth, and the OBS that I was using, it was a great flight, had a very exciting end to the flight as I was coming in about 140 miles from Dallas-Fort Worth International. I had an engine quit. The left engine just suddenly quit, and so I had to fly that last 140 miles out of a 1,000-mile flight on one engine and land it. And right now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you that the only portion of the entire video, because OBS was acting, I don't know what was going on. It was continuously giving me encoder overload and just was not working. And actually about the only portion of the video that worked was the tower view replay. That worked smooth and efficiently, but the rest of the so it was just horrible and basically completely unusable. Needless to say, it was very frustrating. So what I'm going to do right now is we're going to go ahead and we're going to show you some of that raw footage, and yeah, let's take a look at it. And as you can see, this is just portion of it that you see how stuttery it is. It was just very, very bad. But I wanted to show you this part because here I am coming in for the landing, and you can see that the left engine is toast. And just all of a sudden, without warning, the oil pressure completely shut down, and you can see there in the left-hand corner the tower view of the landing. So it was very challenging. And you can see how the one section of the video has basically just big chunks. You know, it stops, it goes, it stops, you know. But the tower view was very smooth and was able to bring it in for, you know, a nice landing. But when that engine first quit, it kept me extremely busy trying to figure out what had happened, pulling back on, you know, trying to feather the prop, shutting down the engine very quickly as far as fuel and RPM, prop RPMs, and of course throttle back to zero, just to save any more damage to the engine that might happen. And you can hear, of course, me cleaning up the aircraft, getting the flaps all up as we got ready to leave the active and move on to the taxiway. So out of a total flight time video, we had about 3 minutes of video that I could use. because OBS was just, it just got stupid. So, unfortunately, it happened. It is what it is. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get ready for the second half of today's flight, which is from Dallas-Fort Worth out to KWJF, which is our home base. And we've had the aircraft worked on, checked and everything. And we'll see how it goes. I am not going to be using my standard OBS. I reinstalled my Streamlabs OBS, and we'll see how things go. So let's get this thing started, and we'll see you inside the cockpit. And I still have no idea what that beeping sound is, but by golly, we're sure going to try and find out. Let me know if you see anything. And we're going to KWJF. So let's go ahead and log in. You're going to tell me that warning was for FSE interface? What the heck? I sure do not know what that is and where it's coming from. But it sure is aggravating. And I've never heard it before in this aircraft. It sounds like the airport's identifier. Airports have send out a signal identifying their which airport it is, and that's what that little Morse code sounded like. Okay, so we're gonna cross here.
Approaching 1-8 right.
Alrighty, so we're just about ready to take off here.
Approaching 1-8 right.
Alright, so let's get and we will get on our way here.
On runway 1-8 right. Flaps.
Gear coming up. Okay, and flaps up. Yeah, we'll work on trimming our bird. Okay. As we say goodbye to Dallas-Fort Worth, and let's go ahead and take a little closer look at that. Was cylinder temp, carb air, oil temp. And these all looked good on yesterday's flight, and then suddenly, boy, the bottom just fell out of oil temp and everything. Miles to go, and of course heading west from the east, we were running away from the sun. So like right now it's about 16 minutes after 6 in California. So in essence we got here before we left. Excuse me there. We are really pushing this lady to her endurance edges here. We are almost out of fuel. Okay, so let's start our descent. And ATIS has told us that we should be running landing on runway 6. So we'll look for that. Squeeze out every last drop of fuel that we can. Just switched back to the left main because it's got a little bit more than the right main does. There's the right main. It's damn near empty. So like I said, we're going to get everything we can out of this girl. And sun rising behind us. What would the wind calm? Okay, let's do 10 miles. 2992. That's already checked. Runway 6. And advise I have X-ray. And I believe that is the airport there. And we are approaching the opposite end of where we need to be. So, Okay, well, my airplane. See the Solus Wings hangar and the Air America Dua hangar, and the runway we want is the one at the far end. Swing out here, and then we'll turn around and come back. Just like this. Landing gear coming down, first stage of flaps.
Approaching 06.
Okay, so flight is finished, so we'll get credit for us being here. Very good. Let's get back in the cockpit. Alrighty, well, we made it 1,027 miles and we used up almost every single drop of fuel available. Let's see if it'll give me that information in the log. Okay, distance, I was wrong. It's 1,062. Alright, yeah, it cost me $1,400. Let's see. Doesn't tell me how much fuel was on board when we got through. Let's see here. We can go back to where KWJF. Let's look at my flight. And she has 19 out of 804 gallons. We have 19 gallons of fuel left. So yeah, we pushed it to her max. So hope you enjoyed it. Had a lot of fun bringing it to you. We'll see you next time when we keep trying to make money. And I sure hope you enjoyed the flight. Hope you enjoy these videos. If you do, please click the like button. And if you don't, click the don't like button. And you have things to say or want to give me suggestions on how to possibly make this more entertaining for you folks and for me to make better videos, please feel free to make comments. I have gotten some wonderful, wonderful comments from you folks that watch my videos, and I appreciate each and every one of them. So, with that, this is BugEater64, and as always, be safe and safe flying.